Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives is a feast for the eyes, with its mouth-watering close-ups of America's favorite comfort food. And above all else, there's Guy Fieri hamming it up for Flavortown fans. So how does it all come together? Here's what the cameras don't show you on Triple D. While the show does its best to capture the atmosphere at all the locations it features, one thing you'll never actually see is what the dining room crowds actually look like when Guy Fieri isn't rolling through town. The Triple D producers need a controlled environment to film in, so those candid shots you see of a dining room full of hungry, excited customers, they are perfectly staged for the cameras.
Very tender, falls off the bone.
It has, like, nothing wrong with it.
It's just perfect.
According to the owners of Season 19's Cafe Nooner, businesses have to agree to close their doors for a few days while the Triple D crew does its thing. So who are all those people you see on screen chowing down and sometimes chatting with Fieri himself? They're loyal customers, family, and friends that have been invited by the restaurant owners to be part of the shoot.
This was my English teacher in my sophomore year of high school. This is Mr. Politano.
It all sounds like a really good reason to start buttering up your favorite local restaurant owners. You never know when it could lead to a chance to meet the mayor of Flavortown himself. You'll never see it on the show, but a lot of food that gets made never gets eaten, all for the sake of getting the ultimate shot. Videomaker spoke with Triple D's executive producers, who explained that there's at least one day of filming at the restaurant before Fieri ever shows up. And part of that process is shooting the kitchen and the beautiful finished dishes that come out of it. As production explained, a burrito would be sitting there, but wasn't all that great looking by itself. So we thought, what about when they're pouring on the hot tomato salsa or the cheese is sliding off the burrito? We really started to embrace that part of the cooking. But that means having to make things multiple times to get the perfect glamour shot. As the owner of Northern Water Smokehouse in Minnesota told Twin Cities Business, "I think it cost us nearly $15,000 in wasted product and costs associated with cleaning."
Brother, you don't need to make anything else.
Then again,
Salamini basket!
There's no doubt Fieri has eaten a lot of food while filming Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives since the show's inception in 2006, and it's statistically impossible that all of those items were delicious. Yet one thing the cameras will never show you on Triple D is anything Fieri wants to spit out on that first bite. And there's a good reason for that. According to show creator David Page, the bar is set high. He told Heavy Table, "Every place we go has to make real food, and it has to be good enough. We are incredibly discerning about what it takes to get on the air." Fieri himself confirmed this, telling People, "Not every dish is A+, but if I don't like it, you won't see it."
Barbecue inside of ramen, normal?
No, however, the flavors really do pair well together.
Of course, not every single thing can be Fieri's favorite. And folks have picked up on that over the years of watching Triple D. The host confessed to the moment that sometimes off camera, a cook will say to him, "Well, you didn't go like this is off the hook." And I'm like, "While it was good, don't be offended. I don't like every song that's on the Rolling Stones album." At the end of the day, Fieri says his intention is to tell fans the true story. When it comes to Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, it's all about Fieri. And he gets the final say in pretty much every decision about the show, the restaurants, and the food that gets featured, according to Thrillist. So that means he can pretty much change his mind whenever he wants.
Shut the front door, the back door, the side door, and all the windows.
If Fieri gets to a location and wants to scrap the plan and have the kitchen whip up something else on the menu, they have to scramble to get it done. That happened to Minnesota restaurant Casper and Runyon's Nook, who revealed to Twin Cities Business, "We cooked every item on the menu 3 times with Guy. He wanted to try everything on the menu just about. Then they decided what to feature." Of course, you'll only see smiling faces, excited chefs, and a pumped-up host in each episode of Triple D. But the one last-minute change you'll never see? David Page told Heavy Table, "To be candid, we have gotten to town and canceled places because the key to the show is that they have to meet our standards." If Guy Fieri is known for one thing, it's having a personality as big as his appetite. And while the show works hard to capture the star in all his funkalicious glory, this is a man who simply cannot be contained on film. And it's not just the aggressive use of Flavortown slang. Fieri is dedicated and involved. He's deliberate about his interactions with the restaurant owners. And then, of course, when the time is right, he whips out the star power and anything can happen. Food Network walked through a typical day of filming on location for Triple D. It started at 7:45 a.m., with Fieri running around the set asking questions because he likes to be as hands-on as possible. When he's not camera-ready, people say he acts and talks just like a regular dude.
I was loading camera gear with my team, and I was putting it back in, and like, talent doesn't lift gear.
Yeah.
And I go, well, good. Well, tell me when the talent shows up.
One restaurant owner recalled to Thrillist, he was a real nice, down-to-earth guy. Then it was like he slipped his Guy Fieri persona on, like a Halloween costume. It's worth noting, though, that Fieri doesn't spend too much time chatting it up with restaurant owners beforehand. One producer told People, that's very important because they're having a genuine, organic moment of meeting each other for the first time on camera. You're always in for a good time with Triple D. You'll get your fair share of Fieri's wisecracks, and you might even see him try and goof around a bit in the kitchen with the chef. Fieri does whatever it takes to make good TV, but it's arguable that the real good time is happening behind the scenes.
Are we in Flavortown right now?
I am at Customs. I am crossing the border.
According to various sources, there's no shortage of goofing around between Fieri and the Triple D crew when the cameras aren't rolling. Jokes abound, as do the pranks. There have even been instances of flying food, according to Food Network, and Heavy Table reported on some sort of game involving hiding meat in random places. At the end of the day, the cameras definitely can't capture just how tight-knit the crew is. Fieri shared with the outlet, "The crew is vital. If I don't have the crew there, then it doesn't work. These are my friends." The chef also mentioned to Videomaker that while he's hosted several different shows over the years, each with their own crew, he's closest to the Triple D gang, adding, "Crew members have paid their dues on this show and are very heavily invested in its success." Considering how long it's been on the air, Triple D is certainly not without its share of behind-the-scenes drama. From creative disagreements to ugly lawsuits, there have been some major speed bumps on the road to Flavortown. Perhaps the biggest scandal to hit the show was the fierce falling out between Fieri and show creator and executive producer David Page. It's unclear exactly what sparked the creative differences between the two, but according to reports, Fieri demanded the network replace Page after 11 seasons. Page didn't go quietly. In 2011, he sued Food Network, claiming Fieri wasn't showing up to film episodes that he and the network were under contract for, per The Hollywood Reporter. Food Network then countersued, claiming that Page had created a hostile work environment. What followed was an ugly back and forth, with harsh accusations flying from both sides. Food Network claimed Page used profane language and intimidation tactics. And according to the New York Post, Page accused Fieri of being difficult to work with, making homophobic comments, and exhibiting lewd behavior on set. Eventually, Page and the Food Network reached a settlement, and a new production team took over Triple D. One of the most epic moments on any episode of the show is when Fieri takes that all-important first bite. The camera locks in on him, and his initial reaction says it all. And when Fieri tastes something amazing, his enthusiasm is unmatched.
That's full speed, man. That's all throttle, no bottle, man. That is just getting it done.
But that first bite doesn't tell the whole story. Sure, sometimes Fieri can't help himself and goes in for a second or a third bite without hesitation, much to the delight of a local chef. But you'll never see just how much Fieri actually eats in a full day of filming. When the host and his crew hit the road, they've got a lot of locations to cover in a short amount of time. So Fieri will often shoot at more than one restaurant in a single day. At each of those restaurants, Fieri chows down on multiple dishes for the camera, sometimes more than once, so production can get every angle they need. That's a whole lot of greasy, cheesy, heavy diner food. So Fieri keeps his on-set diet as light as possible. He told People he drinks a daily green juice, packed with fruits and veggies when he's on the road.
Hey everybody, I'm Guy Fieri and we're rolling out, looking for America's greatest diners, drive-ins, and dives.
No episode will be complete without a shot of Fieri rolling out in his Camaro convertible, seemingly in search of the greatest local bites America has to offer. But if you thought Fieri was actually cruising from town to town in a little red Chevy, you're in for a disappointment. Turns out, the Camaro is just for the cameras. In an interview with People, Fieri revealed that the car is transported to each city in a trailer, and a crew member gets it to each filming location. Besides shooting the intro, Fieri is filmed opening and closing the car door, and that's about it. This might make more sense when you consider the fact that the 68 Camaro is worth about $100,000, according to People. Fieri is also a classic car collector who would probably never put that many miles on one of his treasured pieces. Besides his spiky blonde hair and penchant for slang words involving funk, Fieri is known for being highly involved in charity events and organizations. From fundraising money for disabled children, to serving meals to wildfire victims, to creating the Restaurant Employee Relief Fund to help food workers impacted by the pandemic, raising $24 million in the process. Fieri has had his hands in a range of philanthropic efforts, but perhaps the organization closest to his heart is the Make-A-Wish Foundation. Fieri's connection to Make-A-Wish is personal. He watched his sister beat cancer as a child and then ultimately lose her battle when the disease returned in adulthood. Fieri told Thrillist why he is so heavily involved with the org that grants wishes to children suffering from critical illness, explaining, "I remember what it's like to be in a hospital with her. I remember that feeling of just being bored and tired." As part of his effort to help sick children and their families, Fieri told Delish that he invites a child from the Make-A-Wish Network and their entire family to each taping of the show. You'll never see them on camera, but there will always be that special guest behind the scenes. After dozens of seasons and hundreds of featured restaurants, the Triple D effect is no secret. When the crew decides to roll through town, the local joints that make the cut may never be the same. After the episode airs, what usually follows is a huge windfall of business from locals and hungry tourists alike. According to Thrillist, Fieri tells owners to prepare for a whopping 200% increase in business. And that's just right off the bat. Restaurants also report recurring rushes every time a rerun of their episode airs. And anyone who's watched Food Network knows that Triple D marathons are a common occurrence.
We got so busy afterwards. We actually had to knock the wall down.
Out of anger? Was there a family fight? Is there something happened?
We needed more space.
Still, it's worth noting that appearing on the show doesn't automatically guarantee lasting success for a restaurant. Flavortown USA, which tracks Triple D locations around the country, notes dozens of restaurants that have closed for various reasons since Fieri paid them a visit. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite Food Network shows are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.